This is Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
So
good
we're
to see you again.
We're at Rorik's
How
stead.
Would you like to hire a brave, if untested, mercenary?
What is this place called? Fruit, Frosted Fruit Inn or something like that. Whoa. Oh man. That sucked. I come running out here with no weapon in my hand. Did my weapon dissolve? Do I have a weapon? I had the weapon degradation and flat out destruction cranked up all the way, I think. So it would happen often, because I wanted to see what happens when it happens. But I think now I just have it set for standard settings and.
These vampires are becoming a real menace.
Yeah. I have a feeling we were on our way to Markarth. Not 100% sure. I remember up here there was a shrine up here. And for some reason I thought it was a Talos shrine. Or an Arcane shrine. And I'm like looking all over for the statue of Talos, and it's like, okay, where's the shrine? And instead I find this, saber cat. Of course my companions are taking the long way to get up here. Somewhere around here is a frickin' shrine. Where is it? I know I have diseases and whatnot. I want cured. And I probably need to pray. I haven't done that in a while. Where is it? Like 5 or 6 years ago, in real time, I was out here and I found it. And I remember it. And I've always wanted to come back up here since then. And then when I do... Ah! What is this? You aren't Talos or Arcane. What is this? Akatosh or something? I hardly ever see this shrine anywhere in the game. I forgot this was a thing. Oh, I gotta read the fine print if I want it. I will just get the blessing is all. I'm not gonna join their little cult. That's the house infected with rats. I haven't been there in years either. I haven't been there since probably 2015. Are you like me? You play Skyrim regularly on a regular basis, and there's just certain places in the game you just went to once, and that was enough. You don't need to revisit that place again. Because you know it's just the same old place. Like most of the shacks in the game, I don't go back to. Like Agni, or what's that old lady's name over by Riverwood at the bottom of Bleak Falls Barrow? Oh, I'm just an old woman. Pay no attention to me. I just never go visit her. Unless there's a mod that says I need to go talk to her for some reason. What is it? Interesting persons? Makes you go visit her because all of a sudden she's so fascinating. Gosh darn it, she's just so interesting in the game now. I don't have a cursor. I don't need one. I can pretty much tell where the center of my screen is, so I don't need it. I don't need a frickin' cursor. No, if I save the game, load the game, then it reinitializes the frickin' cursor. For some reason, the minimal HUD that I'm using, it's very light in priority in the game. It lets other mods kick it to the curb. So oftentimes, my minimal HUD isn't doing anything. This is... okay, I shouldn't be able to just kill people with one shot using boring arrows, a boring bow, and I have hardly any archery skill. I'm gonna have to set my difficulty again to something... I don't know. I need something stronger. Every time I install a mod, I have to readjust my difficulty because it throws the scaling off so much.
Hello, friend. In the market for some hunting supplies? Try Hulda, the innkeeper at the Bannered Mare. It's just up the road near the market. You should check in at Dragon's Reach, too. There's so much going on these days. The Jarl or his steward might have need of help. Thank you very much for your business.
Is there something I can do for you? Huh?
I can tell you're no stranger to the wilds.
I understand.
I'm sure we can meet your hunting needs.
So, what were we doing here? Oh, yeah. Playing around with the replacers again.
Arrows and ale. A unique combination, to be sure.
Blade and shadow, silence and death. These are my art. For a modest fee.
Man, she looks hideous. She looks cool, but she looks hideous.
If you change your mind, seek me out here.
I'll be happy to assist you if you'd like to purchase something.
I know nothing of fear and nothing of remorse. Pay my fee, and together we will vanquish any foe.
I was going through a phase where I was downloading female replacers
so
that had
see your foes before they see
just feral war paint on their faces.
I can tell you're no stranger to the wilds.
Just the raw savagery of it all. Now I'm questioning what motivated me to do that.
Can I help you? Please.
I was looking for a replacer for her, but she already. Uthgar already has character. She doesn't need. She doesn't need changed looks, as far as I know.
We sell bows, arrows.
Less commerce means less money.
Thank you so much for taking care of those thieves. The Riverwood trader is back to the way it used to. I think I have a few old spell books laying about. If you want more, you'll have to go to the College of Winterhold.
So I had gone in the Wayback Machine, and I had... I want to say I went back to, like, right. Level 2 or level 3? Because I had ripped out some mods, and so I had to go back to before I installed those mods. So now I want to say this is before I've gone to Dragon's Reach to inform the Jarl about the dragon, I think.
Not waste
yes?
time browsing stores.
Take a look.
That's one thing of my wife I'm glad to be rid of.
I was shocked that this merchant had so much gold. So I'm like, okay, here, take all this stuff I found at Bleak Falls Barrel. And I'm just torturing myself now doing these videos because I can't play Skyrim. And I'm seeing all kinds of new mods being uploaded to the Nexus that I want to try out. And I cannot, not with my Intel 4000 high def card built into the motherboard circa 2012.
I admire the curiosity of the
option. It'll let me run Skyrim, but just to do beauty shots using screen capture, that's about it. I can't actually move in the game because the frame rate is like 2.5 or 3, which means no Skyrim for you. So here's my revamped Irelith with the bobbed hair. Oh.
I can teach you a few things.
Teach me something.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're in for it.
So I took out this tree that was always blocking their way.
I said a dragon. I don't much care where it came from. What I do know is that it's made the mistake of attacking.
And these elite Whiterun guards, they're everywhere.
That's a fair question.
Every town has elite guards now.
Or expected to face one in battle. But we are honor-bound to fight it, even if we fail. This dragon is threatening our homes, our families. Could you call yourselves Nords if you ran from this monster? You going to let me face this thing alone?
No, Haltar.
But it's more than our honor at stake here. Think of the first dragon.
Okay, so I went back in the game to where
the glory of killing it is ours.
I get to if kill the dragon me. Again.
Now what do you say? Shall we go kill us a dragon?
Yeah!
Damn right!
Let's move up.
They have a certain pecking order that they run in, so that's why they're acting weird like that. Let's see.
You lost?
Well, let's give you back your,
of course.
Blacksmith outfit.
I understand.
So I have to go through and give everyone.
I think you'll be glad that you made this decision.
Give everyone the outfits that they had earlier. Just to keep lore continuity going on. In my playthrough. What else did I change around here? So yeah, I installed Denizens of Morthal, which is an amazing. It's an amazing mod, but it only covers Morthal. I like it way better than Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul. It makes the citizens of Morthal do things, gives them schedules, instead of just standing around in one spot waiting for you to ask about the burned out house. That's all they're useful for.
Greymane or Battleborn.
And when they're followers of you, they have things to say.
I could tell you were a sharp one the moment I laid eyes on you.
They tell you how they're feeling.
Stay safe.
They talk to other NPCs. They have new dialogue. It also changes their looks, which I didn't like, so I'm keeping the looks that I already have for my NPCs. I don't want denizens of Morthal changing how my NPCs look. And then while I was doing that, I installed Pandora's NPCs, and for whatever reason, I thought it changes dudes also.
Now please, no more questions.
But apparently the mod only changes females. Is that true? Pandora NPCs only does females?
If it's work you're looking for, Hulda's the one to talk to. Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both.
It's weird how that that RXKX whatever guy, if it is a guy, does the War Maidens.
I have work to do.
All the War Maidens in the game get changed, you know. They all look like hot stuff. So why not make a guy version of War Maidens or something? What? Every time I look for a guy replacer, all I find is boy band. You know, Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, Justin Bieber. That's the only kind of guys I find for these male replacers. Is there a mod called True Nords? You call yourself a Nord?
If you need more food or drink, speak to Hulda.
I'm tired of these milk drinker mods for guys. I want guys to look like I want them to look like
Mind
Nords.
Mind your manners and pay your bills, and you'll always be welcome. It's been a pleasure.
But, you know, Skyrim, you know, to be honest, Skyrim is played by more than just guys and girls. It's played by the homosexual crowd. And there's a lot of guys who mod Skyrim. Basically for other guys who are into that kind of stuff. So you got the bear crowd, you got the other crowd, you got the other things. And then there's poor me who just wants guys. Is it so hard to ask? But I look at the guy replacers and I'm like, okay, that's not me. That's not my kind of eye candy. But for a lot of guys, that's their eye candy.
Have you by any chance seen a huge drowned Nord and a filthy little wood elf bastard?
Oh, there's Vili. I'm still looking for a replacer for her.
From squire to squire.
Anytime.
Like I said in a previous video, she might just end up being that way for the rest of my playthrough. If I can't find a better hairstyle or face. I mean, I've used one in the past, but there's gotta be others.
Need something?
I've tried like 20 or 30.
Stay out of trouble, Imperial.
And they all kinda look More than half of them don't make they make Vilya not look like Vilya anymore. Yeah, it makes Vilya look like
work you're looking for,
like another character who wouldn't sound like Vilya when she talks.
No more questions.
You know, that would be really boring if Vilya sounded like Lydia and looked like Lydia. I mean, what would be the point of that?
If you need more food or drink, speak to Hulda. If there's nothing else.
Anyway, so this is one of the Pandorable NPCs, Sadia. This is what she looks like. If I can get a decent lighting on her. God, it's so crowded in here. Who made this kitchen? It sucks. It's so hard to get from one end to the other without hopping over the stove, burning yourself just to get over here. Like, no one ever uses that door. Hardly anyone ever goes in or out that door. Because it's a pain to get to. Let's see. I think I changed Carlotta's outfit.
I'm going to buy the Bannered Mare from Hulda.
But yeah, I don't know what these elite guards are. These elite Whiterun guards. What are they for?
I spend a lot of time at the market stall so I can learn the merchant's trade. I need more experience if I'm going to run.
Because the denizens of Morthal adds more than just new dialogue.
This should turn that old cat's gaze.
It adds new guards to the game. I don't know why. Each hold has more new guards.
Let me show you a thing or two about bargaining. Don't want some shifty merchant giving you a raw trade.
Maybe it's to help ensure that NPCs live, because the mod
good talking to you.
Assumes that NPCs are going to live in your game so they can talk to your new followers you have with you. Maybe having better guards in the town helps the town folk survive long enough for them to say their new lines with your Newfound companions from Marthal.
What do you need, handsome?
Like a, she's in his spot, so he won't sell anything until she moves. But it's already too late. She's locked in on that spot. She's just gonna walk right back over there. Because that's what her schedule has her doing.
What is it now? Strangers are nothing but trouble.
So I left her alone. I didn't let Pandorable NPCs modify her. All of the normal attractive women in my game are still the original vanilla ones, like Helga from Riften, the gray main lady there from Whiterun. Who's the other knockout? Susanna the Wicked at Windhelm. She's unmodded.
I don't care what you're doing. After what happened, you're lucky I don't toss you in jail. Now get lost.
We will be back. This is not over.
Okay, I totally forgot about these guys.
You there. We're looking for someone in Whiterun. We'll pay good money for information. A woman, a foreigner in these lands. Redguard, like us.
These guys always show up.
We will pay for
whether you go to the Whiterun Watchtower or not. They're going to show up.
So we will be in Rorikstead if you
they're going to show up whether you become Thane or no Thane.
We'll find her eventually.
But they show up around the same time that dragon shows up.